Next.js sent middleware to general release. So let's talk about it. So with the release of Next 12.2, middleware has gone to general release. And with that comes a lot of breaking changes. The breaking changes include no response bodies, no more nested middleware, no more page match data, the cookies API got revamped, and a few other changes that you can read about in the link below. So with these changes, middleware became easier to implement. Here is an example of a project using middleware before 12.2, and as you can see, there are multiple middleware files depending on what pages are being used. And here is 12.2. As you can see, now we have one middleware file. It's no longer nested, which makes it easier for you to be able to handle middleware. You'd also notice that the underscore is now missing from the file name, and that's because the prefix is no longer required. So you put this next to your pages directory and everything is handled from there. The no response body is a big change. Before, you could send out something like this on screen where you could tell somebody in the response body that they are 401 not authorized or something similar. With the changes to general release, you're now going to be using rewrites and redirects to handle this. So no more response body, that won't work anymore. And doing something like this instead will allow the user to be redirected based upon conditions that you have. So if your user is not authorized, send them back to the login screen where they can sign into their account and start using it. In middleware prior to 12.2, you could do things like response.cookie and then set your cookie to whatever you wanted. That's no longer the case. They've now actually got a set that you can use to set your cookies. You also have now got rid of clear cookie and now you have cookie.delete. And you also have the options to do cookies.clear, which will mark all of them as expired. User agent is now a helper. Before, you used to have the option to access it from the request. Now you have a Next.js helper. And the reason behind this is to save on kilobytes. Before making these changes, it added an additional 17 kilobytes to the request. So being able to remove the user agent from this allows you to now reduce the size of middleware, and it actually gives you better options. So before, if you wanted to detect whether they were on mobile or desktop, you could do something like this, where you used request.ua.device and then decide what to do with mobile or desktop. But now with the new helper, instead of doing it this way, you can import user agent and then use that request to detect what kind of device they're on or any other parts that you might get from a user agent. This allows you to reduce the middleware down if you're not using user agent at all. And of course, with the helper, you get this new set of features. So there you have it. Middleware is now in general availability and you can use it however you want. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to leave it a like, subscribe, and of course, tell me what kind of content you want to see on the channel, because this channel is for you and I make the content you guys want.